Hello and welcome back to Planet Coaster. Okay, so back in good old Winter Dongland, we got some real crazy shit going on. So last time, we of course built, I don't know, this weird sort of gingerbread space center or whatever it is, and we have yet to decorate it with icing and whatnot, so we will go ahead and do that at some point. That is a whole lot of effort though. I wonder if did that affect the scenery at all? I wish there was like some sort of, I don't know, heat map for scenery rating to see where it's lower, see where it's higher, but I don't think that's a possibility. But oh well. Be cool to know, because, you know, I think scenery is just straight up said by how expensive things are. But who really knows? And I don't care. So, Balloon Cellar is still popping off here. Like, Jesus Christ. You don't have enough money to visit the balloon? That's why there's an ATM, dog! I'm so 4% of people say the ATM is free, and they're happy about that, and I'm happy about that for them. Anyway, let's go ahead and unpause it while we have the chance here. Oh my God, you are rocking it, King Coaster. I get paid what I'm worth. This job is great. I'm just 36 guests are entertained by you, and can you also sell some hats and balloons while you're there? Great, thank you. Hats, fantastic. What happened, dog? Do we just live in a world where everyone has a hat and we've fulfilled the hat market? Do we not need this many hats anymore? We just need balloons and pictures? How's Just a Memento doing? That also did really well. Assumably more people need mementos. What do they sell? That's right, bullshit. They sell bullshit. And the balloon seller is doing crazy too. Anyway, that's not important because we always make money from balloons and whatnot. So, because we spent so much time building that gingerbread house, we did accumulate quite a... Whoa! Hold on. We need to do some administrative stuff, apparently. Where is all of the sick happening? Is it outside of the cube? Yeah, that's gotta be it right there. Let's go ahead and, of course, throw down some path extras. Trash can. Normal bench piece. Yeah, we'll just throw down one bench. Maybe we'll throw down a few benches on the outside over here, too. But then we definitely need to hire another janitor. Unless we did that recently. Though I don't remember. We only have one janitor? I'm going to hire a janitor. And I'm going to do something I've never done before. And that would be making a roster for him to work at. So, I want him to just be the VOM guy. So, he's got to work the cube. And I believe there's quite a bit of vomit coming out of that one as well. I don't think there's a whole lot. Maybe over here too, the forge? So yeah, this will be called the vomit roster. Because I just need him to be on point with... Oh, this only has one ride. At least edit. So this guy, and that guy, and that guy. I have to shift click apparently. Alright, save that. There we go. You are working the vomit roster, buddy. You need to just be here. Where'd he go? Hello? Hello? Did anybody see where he went? Mr. Janitor? You need to get on the vomit roster, dog. Okay, you're on the vomit roster. Everyone else is just free roaming. I hope we don't have a litter problem. I don't see any laying around. Do people say anything about the litter? Puppetry, the penis of the penis. God, I love a good penis. And vagina. Let's go ahead and lower the price of puppetry, the penis. Because apparently, people ain't liking it too much anymore. Also, the fact that it's just, like, not working efficiently is always bugging me. But people aren't exactly happy about it. How's this one doing? Not well either. But they're calling it good value. I'll even up it to $7. Why not, right? It's still really cheap for a coaster. Okay, any other administrative stuff? 29% of people stepped in sick. There's got to be vomit somewhere else, right? Is there vomit here? I don't see any vomit there. There's definitely no vomit coming off of that thing. Or this thing. Where's all the vomit at? It's got to be hiding. Any out of here? No, there's not even people riding out of that thing. I don't know where the vomit went. Vomit's hiding. We don't even make money from rides anymore. We're here to exist to sell shops and hats. We might as well make every ride free, pretty much. Okay, so the vomit's hiding from me, but hopefully that gets cleared up soon, since we did hire a new janitor. But other than that, yeah, I don't know where the vomit would be. It definitely can't be out of here, right? Oh, fuck, we found it. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and hire another janitor and just plop him down right there, pretty much. And just clean that up. Just clean that up right now, because that is an accumulation of vomit. What are people saying about this place? It's expensive? Holy fuck, man. It's getting really frustrating that people don't ride these things. Okay, we've got a ton of money in the bank. It would just make my life easier to just delete all these fucking guys, okay? They aren't doing a damn thing. So let's go ahead and just put down another Wild Blue. Which I believe was orientated somewhat like that. Throw down the entrance, throw down the exit, and there we go. We've got another... Well, we pretty much have another Wild Blue, if we can just dock it up here. Okay, we'll have to back it up a little bit. I would not like it to be that wide. Okay, there we go. Got another Wild Blue, even though it's moved back quite a ways. Go ahead and delete the carousel as well. Just get that right out of there. Carousel, you have failed me once again. Throw you back down right in that pocket, though. Place entrance. Place exit. Boobity-bobity-boo. Open up the carousel. Did we open up Wild Blue? We did not. Let's go ahead and do that. Whirly Rig, you are also getting fucking out of here. We're just going to replace all of these rides because we've got the money. And it pays off in the long run by quite a bit. Like, people love the rides. They just need incentive. And they hate old rides, apparently. So we've got the Whirly Rig. We've got the teacups. Teacups, teacups, teacups. Teacups, teacups, teacups. Right there. Place the entrance. Place the exit. Open up the teacups. We've got Tony Cox Pro Skater, which will no longer be named, unfortunately, but... It is annoying me. So we'll throw that down right there. You know what? I wouldn't have done this if we had built more rides in, like, the interim period, but we just haven't built that many rides recently and haven't been researching them too well. So it's honestly, it would just be better to just pretty much delete them, throw them back down again, as just to give people something to do. Because I don't know what rides they're going on, honestly. Like, they're just bailing out of everything. Why can I not put you down? In a normal spot, please. Insanity. Why ain't you working? Alright, we're gonna have to go back and delete the pass a little bit. There we go. Now we can put it back down. Just finagle it a little bit. There we go. Come on. How do you not fit right there? Okay, you fit right there at least. I don't know what's going on. There must be something with the height. Entrance can go right there. Exit can go right over there. That trash is full. Apparently we just don't have enough janitors. That might be something to look at. Weirdly enough, brain power over here was doing pretty well. Although it is expensive and old. So we'll go ahead and delete that one too. Throw Cicola back down. Because, you know, why not? We've got the money and it pays off. It pays off so much. Place exit. There we go. Don't want to get anybody stuck. Why is that not working? Nope, that's not what I wanted. That ain't what I wanted. Huh. Okay, this is awkward. Can we replace the entrance? Why is that not working out anymore? Huh. This is weird. I'd love if this would just connect. We've just built a staircase. Okay. This is so awkward. Oh, we had it. We had it. Did you see that we had it? How did we have it before? There it was. Okay, we got it to work. Let's go ahead and close it. What about the next guy? Coctopus? Yeah, it's not doing too well either. Let's go ahead and remake that one. What is the Coctopus? It's the Rocktopus. I see. The play on words we had, right? I'm so clever. There we go. Throw it right there. These hills are making these entrances a little awkward, but it should be okay. Whoops. These guys don't even have too high of prestiges anyway. I don't know. Maybe people just aren't into the same things they've been into. Is anybody even on the damn Matterhorn? This thing is depressingly empty. Do we have to replace the Matterhorn? Because, like... Nobody rides this thing. We had, what, 9 guests last month. That is sad. That is very sad. We have 2,000 guests, and I'm pretty sure they all go to the shops, and that's it. We have a new challenge? Okay. Whatever. Oh, boy. I don't know. This is so bizarre. I guess, I don't know, replace the Matterhorn, right? This would be under my blueprints. Puppetry Matterhorn. There it is. Okay. Just throw this baby back down into the ground. How did we get this to work? Like, we got it to go under here somewhere. Oh. It was there for a brief moment. I swear, officer, it was there. It was always there at one point. Oh, okay. Right there works. We can just adjust these cues a little bit. Place the exit, like, right there. And we'll just dock the path over here. There we go, perfect. We can not open this because it has to test, okay. Let's go ahead and unpause this while we're doing this. I don't think anybody's ever been on the Magic Twirl, but you know what? Fuck it, get out of here, Magic Twirl. It's a piece of garbage. Oh, Magic Twirl will put you back down, though, because I believe in you, Magic Twirl. Everybody's got to have a fair chance. Please get the path down here, though. We didn't even build scenery for this thing, which is pretty sad. Any other rides, really? I don't really think so. The Forge, MC Hammer Daddy, and our two new guys are doing very well for themselves. So other than that, I think we're good on rides, unless we want to re-put down the puppetry of the penis, but I don't think that's necessary, really. Can we open this guy yet? Where's the test? Oh, it's barely at the beginning. Okay. Okay, so yeah, that'll clear up some administrative stuff, just to get that out of the way. We might as well also train our staff here. Here we go. All these guys need to be a little bit more proficient. You guys also need your salaries to be increased to the baseline, and now we can open the Matterhorn again. It's perfect, okay? People will get on, hopefully. What's the prestige at? 627? That's better than it was before, right? Anybody on any of our rides? Yeah, there's a few people on Wild Blue. Even the carousel has a few people on it. Whirly Rig? Yeah, there they go. Okay, so we're flowing some traffic back to those rides, which is nice. You know, not entirely important to the matter of things, but I'm glad. I'm glad our new rides are doing well, too. These look pretty. I like the torches and all the Christmas lights over here. That's lovely. Anyway, that was research doing. We did just spend like 15 grand. Oh, we do get a few research done. We got the boa. Oh, shit, man. Okay, and we got Street Fox Coffee, which will go down in our mall thing. And we got sci-fi scenery. What do we want here? I don't know. We might as well get another research. I would like to start getting track rides out of the way here, and we'll get pirate scenery theme done. Just another thing out of the way. Research is pretty expensive overall, but that'll be okay, I think. So yeah, we can go ahead and throw Street Fox Coffee down, I'm thinking, at least. Where's that? Drink shops, custom drink shops. When did we get all these? I don't know, but whatever. We'll throw down coffee, because I think coffee's got the best chance of doing well in here. Can we add this to the building, please? Okay, and then throw it down, like, right there. And then hit done. There we go. Apparently that worked out. And then, what pathing did we use? Was it this one? It was that one, wasn't it? We'll even make the path a little bit wider, like all the others. There we go. Okay. Looks good. I think people will enjoy that. Is it open? It's open. Alright, another store to come to. This place is kind of kicking it. I like it. I like it a lot. I'm glad that's a popular place. Anyway, do we want to build the boa around our mountain here? Because I'm still waiting for the coaster that's worthy to fight the mountain. Venom? What is this, the one? Is this the... Yeah, okay. That's that one. But no, what about the boa? What does it do? So it's a chain lift, it can invert, and it's for adults and teens only. That might be pretty cool. I was thinking maybe more of a, you know, a standard kind of roller coaster, you know, something like the American Arrow, I like the fact that it can invert, is for adults and teens only. Like, I'm a fan of that stuff, and chain lifts are fine, but I don't know if I want the inverted or the, you know, the hanging down one instead of the standard car right now, because I don't know if that would work aesthetically too well. But I will go ahead and build this coaster, I guess. We can go ahead and do that. I think that'll work out. Why don't we throw down another coaster? Maybe we throw it down over in this section over here. Yeah, why don't we throw something down over here? This part is a little bit empty, and I'm saving this space over here for the mountain ride. So let's go ahead and throw it down. Maybe out here. We probably want a path coming out here a little bit. So we'll throw it down. We'll throw it down like right about here. Oh, you know what? I like the idea of what they did with the blueprint for this coaster, in which they made sort of a smaller, more compact coaster. I would love to do something like that, and I would love to maybe build out the paths over here just to sort of frame what I want going on with this coaster. So maybe we do something like this, where we make a little bit of a, I don't know, question mark shape, I guess, is what this is going to look like. We'll come out here a little bit over in this direction, and then, I don't know, we'll turn it in. Something like that. You know what? I think that looks okay. Might have to come in a little bit earlier than that. It still looks a little awkward. Okay, that'll work. Okay, I think that's a good framing. It's not exactly symmetrical, but I think that'll be okay. Because then we still have room over here for stuff, and then we have a path we can build up the mountain over here, but this will just make it a more compact coaster. Because I think those are pretty cool if you can get them to function. So I'm thinking, where do we want to start this? We probably want a bit of a build-up for the chain lift, but we also want to leave some room in the back for the exit. I think maybe we throw it down, like, right about here. But then, you know, first things first, we do have to change the station to be exit right, enter right. And maybe even make it a little longer. Can we make the car a little longer? We can't. I don't think this is going to be one of those coasters that's so long it needs two cars. So we'll just go ahead and start building the chain lift, right? Extend this out to, I don't know, 20 meters? And then just shove it up. Straight up. 60 degree chain lift. Gotta love those. The standard technique for my roller coaster building, of course. Is that tall? That is pretty tall. I don't know if it doesn't need to be that tall for such a compact coaster. I don't think so. What if we just reduce that a little bit? It's still certainly it's a reasonable tall coaster. Like, it may be the same height as the Matterhorn, just about. Maybe even a little taller. I think that's okay. We don't need a whole lot of speed if we're not going very far. This is not going to be one of those 800 meter coasters. And the high speed probably won't get there either. Okay, yeah, what are our challenges, just for reference? We need to reach 70 miles per hour is probably not going to happen. I'll tell you that much. That needs probably a bigger of a drop. 800 meters long, also not going to happen. It's a compact one, so go ahead and throw those out of the window, really. But what do we want to do here? We definitely got to drop them down somewhat, right? And I think 67.5 here is going to be a good start. Then honestly, like, I think we just got to do some crazy-ass rolls if we want to stay this compact. That seems unfortunately too big. I mean, I would love to do that, but yeah, that's gonna be too tight. Batwing roll? I don't know if we'll get through. Can we make it any smaller? We really can't. I think that would be pretty cool, but I don't think... Yeah, all these are gonna be a little too steep, too big for just one 67.5 meter drop. What if we did two of those? Okay, what if we did, like, one and a half of those? Let's reduce this back to, like, 10 meters if possible. Okay, the camera's being finicky with it though. There we go. Okay, so we'll put it down to, what is that, like 25 meter drop? Okay, and then we do a roll. I want to invert it back a little bit because we have to use this space over here instead of getting too close to the mountain. But what kind of cutback roll do we want? Do we want a demonic pretzel knot? I don't think so. Do we want a sea serpent? That kind of puts us out in the wrong direction though. Sea dive doesn't really work. Inverted horseshoe is a bit too big, I think. Whoa, that would be pretty cool, wouldn't it? warp, what is this called? A warp around corkscrew right? That would be pretty crazy, I think. I don't know, that might be a little too crazy. Why don't, we could save that for the end. And that's, oh. I like that, except the start, it might be a little nauseating there. So let's, I think we've got our best chance with one of these rolls. Either like the serpent roll, or the cobra roll, or maybe even the butterfly inversion roll. No, that one's not going to work out. Or a batwing roll. Bowtie? No, I wanted to point back in. So, we've pretty much got a... Oh, not a banana roll either. Okay, so batwing? What are our choices? Batwing or cobra roll? I kind of like the look of cobra roll more than the batwing roll. And we've used batwing roll before, so you know what? I'm more interested in putting this guy in. If we can make it through. Because this is as small as it's getting. Why don't we go ahead and start the test and unpause it just to make sure it can get through stuff like that? Keep it up to date, you know. I don't know. I guess we gotta drop them again, right? And maybe even like tilt it a little bit. Probably not like that. Yeah, probably something like that. And then pull it up. And then I don't know. Why don't we pull them up a little bit here? Can we just do some like a standard loop then? Not a sidewinder, that's not gonna... Ooh, that'd be pretty good, that'd be pretty tight. Gives us the rest of the room over here too. I like that a lot, I like that idea. Let's go ahead and see if they can make it through. That one they probably definitely can make it through, maybe even a little bit too fast. I'm worried about this serpent roll, or cobra roll, or whatever the hell we call it, man. I don't know, it's a roll, it cuts back, it flips them upside down, it makes people piss their pants, that's all that's important. It can't actually make it through that thing, that is pretty sad. Oh, of course what we do need to do is up the speed of this chain to 14 instead of 4. That might help a little bit. Let's go ahead and start and stop that. I don't think it'll give them any more speed, but at least it'll get them to the top of the hill faster. Because, boy, that is always a low excitement part, is those long, drawn-out chain lifts. Yeah, let's see. Can you get through that? I don't think it's going to change a damn thing. I'm going to be honest. Let's go ahead and see. The cube has been fixed. That's lovely. Good to hear. Oh, and up and... Wow. No. Okay. Okay, delete that guy, and we'll even delete the ones leading up to that thing. Okay. Unfortunately, that didn't work. It might have to be a batwing. Like, actually might have to be a batwing. I can't think of anything else. The cobra roll brings you up too much. The butterfly spits you out the wrong direction. And then these cutbacks are just kind of lame as hell. So I guess we'll give them a batwing. Batwing left. Gives them a little more space to come out, too. We'll see, though. Okay, yeah, excitement gets really high in that first drop, but so does nausea gets a little bit high. They can't even make it through the batwing! Oh my god, it's crazy. I can't believe it. Okay, I guess we have to delete this piece. That piece isn't going to work, apparently. I don't want to drop him like that, though. Boy, I guess we need to give him a little more speed to get through anything that really cuts back here. Drop him one more, and then, I don't know, give him a... I don't know, I would still like to give him a cobra roll if possible. That might be enough speed. Oh, throw it down real quick. Can they make it through that this time? Nausea's pretty high, but it looks like they can make it through. Ooh! Okay, excitement dips a little low there, not gonna lie, like that's a little low. Okay, what if we come up back here? Okay, just delete all that, that's not helpful right now. What if we come back to even this first starting piece? No, okay, get out of here, I swear to god, and drop it down to 90. Like, that's pretty intense, but it'll conserve space and even get them going a little faster. Okay, you're dead. See you later, guys. Crash into the ground. Now you're fucking dead. How does it feel? Okay, roll. Still give him a cobra roll. Shrink it down. Okay, that might even be too small now. Give it... What's a good size, do we think? Because they're going to have a lot of speed coming off of that. Okay, throw them into that. Keep them above the ground, though. And then throw them into a... That one, was it? Yeah, it was that one, but now it's awkwardly placed. Where was it? There it is. Can they get through that? Yeah, they can get through that pretty stellarly, actually, which is pretty good. I think the stats were looking good through the other cobra roll as well. Okay, so they're coming off of that. I don't know. Throw them up a little bit. Gotta give everybody a little bit of airtime, but how do we want to do that? Oh, I like that. Oh, we already have one of those, pretty much. Okay, yeah. What if we put this out one more and then do that sidewinder to the left? I like that. That'll give them a little bit of airtime, hopefully, and put them in the right direction towards the exit. Okay, so yeah, they're making it through that with good stats. Excitement dips a little low there, but then it comes back up through that element. And then, will they make it through this sidewinder? Oh, yeah, pretty good hang time too. Slows them down just a tiny bit. Yeah, so they're still going here. And I guess they'll drop down a little bit more. Is there some other kind of cutback we can give them then to get them towards the exit? I don't want to give them another one of those. Or a pretzel loop. That's just not going to work. That puts them in the fucking ground. That is not going to work. That is just a vertical loop. That'd be cool, but I don't think it's going to work. We might need to give them a longer roll like we were talking about here at the end. Not one of these horseshoes. That's a little bit too long. But these warp around corkscrews maybe? Yeah, what about these warp around corkscrews? They do need to be going a little bit higher. Something like that. And then, where was it? Warp around corkscrew. All the way at the bottom, of course. Naturally. Still not quite tall enough. Warp around corkscrew. God, it's down here. It's down here. Just go. I think we need to control Z it back up a little bit. Something like that. And then put them in the warp around corkscrew. Yeah, to the right. Just like that. Okay, now hopefully they can make it into that. Oh, unfortunately they can't. Okay, so go back. Can we even go back to here? Mellow it out a little bit. Okay, I don't know. Put them up again then, and then throw them into the thing. I just got to keep them high enough at the end here, too, to get over the path and back into the entrance. Okay, now if they can make it through that, they're going to be a little bit tilted, and I can understand why. So, throw them back there. Maybe even call this a trim break, honestly. Or a friction break. Because they are going pretty fast here. And then normal track it back to the start somehow? It's going to be a tough, tight turn here, too. Okay, well, we'll see. It's a completed coaster, technically. And, you know, technicality is my specialty, but it might be a little bit scary. It might be a tiny bit scary for him. We'll go ahead and see. So, yeah, excitement gets real high right at the start there. Whoa. Fear gets up there a little bit. Nausea is a little bit as well. But they're okay. Excitement drops. Excitement comes back up. Nausea goes up. There we go. I'd love to bleed on the nausea there. Excitement even bleeds a little bit. And fear. But they're keeping it going. They're keeping it going. And then they're coming back through this corkscrew left. Yeah, that'll give them a good roll. What do we think? And then they come back to the exit. A little fast, actually. A little fast. Oh, shit. That's perfect. Nausea is real low, considering. Fear is, like, right above where the minimum is. 0.5. And then excitement is almost 8. I'd love it if we could make it to 8. Where's excitement lacking, though? Excitement's lacking down here. I would love if I could fix this ending part a little bit. Because it is a little too fast. Like, they're going full fucking speed here. What if we turn that into a trim brake? That's not a friction brake. It won't slow them down that much. But it'll slow them down more than they were previously. So let's go ahead and see. Actually, why don't we just go ahead and ride the goddamn thing? Okay, get us on there. I want to see what it's like to be a real human being who enjoys exciting things like going outside. Whoa, it's taking us up. Get to see the beautiful mountains. Look at that beautiful scenery even back there. Oh, shit, it's perfect. And this is what I call a compact coaster. And I don't need a jacket. Okay. Good speed there. Oh, boy. Upside down. All around. Whoa, even back around. That's rattling me back and forth. Oh, my goodness. A loop? You can't do that to me. That's crazy. Another loop? Oh, boy. Ooh. But that one gives you a little bit of hang time. Get to enjoy the experience. And then one final corkscrew here. And then you friction break down. And get put back into the exit. Fear and nausea seemed a little bit better there at the end. But it did give us similar results in excitement and fear. So let's go ahead and just stop the test, really. I'm not sure what there is else to do about the excitement. I think... We might be able to throw, like, one more element in here somewhere. Where else is excitement low? Excitement's pretty low going into this thing. I don't know, maybe it's just going too slow. Can we somehow turn this into a small loop? Like, I know that's stretching it quite a bit here. Like, that might be too much to ask for them. But let's go ahead and turn off this heat map. I don't know. Is it possible? Just a small standard vertical loop, pretty much. Even get it smaller if possible. Yeah, something like that. I don't know. Can we back this up even one more? Just give them another. Just give them something to do in that intermediate time, because they get a little bit bored. And then dock them back up. Let's go ahead and try this. This might be too much for them, in all honesty. Testing start test. Let's go ahead and see. I would love it to be the case that it keeps excitement up and even stays nausea low, because you know with these loops they don't have a whole lot of G forces putting on their side. It's all vertical. But hopefully that should keep excitement up through that section. It does get a little low. Hopefully they'll also keep their speed to make it through the rest of the track. It did seem like they were going pretty fast through the rest of the coaster, but you never know. It's that 1 mile an hour difference, baby. Alright, dropping down through that. They're going pretty fast. They do really like that part and that drop. And then I think this one keeps it up. It makes excitement even go up a little bit. This one keeps excitement up and it keeps fear in a good place. And then that part's a little bit shaky on the fear and nausea, but they bleed it off pretty well before going into the final corkscrew area. If we could even throw like another loop here, honestly, like do the same sort of thing where we throw another element in, that'd be good. But what do they have to say? So, nausea did get a little bit higher, but I think that's still reasonable. Fear also got higher, and excitement only went up like 0.2 or something a little bit lower than I would like. Maybe that's just the awkward angling of this thing. Like, if we could just like smooth this out somehow, I don't really know. That's not really working out. Because, yeah, they do come into this a little bit awkward, a little bit sharp, honestly. Like, oof, that's going to really rattle you. Maybe even... I don't know if I want to. Okay, why don't we do some last-minute editing here? We're gonna throw them out forward one more, and then throw them into whatever the hell that thing was. Anybody remember what the hell that thing was? I'm having a hard time remembering what I built. It wasn't a demonic knot. Was it one of these guys? No. Was it one of these loops? I think it was just a loop. It was just a loop, right? Like one of those guys? Oh, it was a sidewinder. That's right. Okay, I don't know. Can we get it to do something like that, too? But we do have to delete that piece, then. Okay, so yeah, it was a loop. It was a sidewinder left. Yeah. I would love to get them pointed in the right direction. I don't want that to be too nauseating on them, though. Okay. So now they're coming out of that straight. And we do have to try to dock them back up with that. But do we have the space? Do we have the space to throw them into another loop? A smaller loop, of course. Something like that. I don't know. We have to figure this out. Let's go ahead and try it. Can we figure out how to dock this back together? Because this is going to be a tight turn then, if that's the case. That's going to be, like, real nauseating on them, I have a feeling. Can we bring this back a little bit? Okay, what if we work from this side? I think that might be easier. They're gonna have to come back up. Oh god, that is really gonna throw them for a tight loop here. Because they have to go up so much, really. That might be a little bit smoother. Can we go ahead and just like smooth all this banking a little bit? Okay. Okay, let's go ahead and try it. Because I'm not sure what they're going to feel about that. We might just have to control Z our way back to what we had. But I'm curious to see if they'll be happy with that. Let's honestly take it for a ride, too. Because I'm curious. I want to know what the changes. Make it a little more exciting, a little less exciting, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. If you like what you see, you'll see what you get. Here we go. Apparently I'm a little mega binge now. Here we go. Whoa. That's so fast, man. Whoa. Is it? Okay, that's 3 speed. I can't believe this is so fast for 1 speed. Through so many loops. That's a loop. And then we even come back through a sidewinder over here. Excitement dipped down quite a bit for going through so many different things. Through another loop. Excitement was high there. And then, ooh, that really brought up nausea a lot. Like, a lot. That awkward turn we had. Okay, if excitement gets above 8, I'll be happy. Oh my god, 7.86. You bastard, honestly. Like, I don't know why excitement's not getting up too much higher. It's still low in the place it's always going to be low, which is the climb. And then everywhere else, it's above 6. Which is honestly, like, pretty good. Maybe we just don't have enough speed to go through all of this. Maybe we can make some of these even tighter. Oh, but that's really worrisome, honestly. If I could fix this area, too, that'd be fantastic. Because I assume this is where all the fear... Yeah, the fear and nausea really go up. Right there. Just because of this sort of funky piece we put in. Which is a little annoying. But it's just not gonna do much better. I'm not a huge fan of that one. What if we just control Z it all the way back? Just all the way back. Just get rid of all these loops. Cause I was happy with our original plan here. Yeah, okay, so I think that's good. We'll just leave it like this. We'll go ahead and start the test and then we'll save it for next time. Let's just go ahead and throw them for a loop here. 3 speed, get it done. Because I'm much happier with a lower fear and lower nausea for the lower excitement. Like that, yeah. We only ended up putting the excitement up, like what? By like 0.2 over the 2 loops, but we put fear up at least 1 and nausea at least 1. I don't think that's a good trade-off. So I think this is a fine coaster. I think it's a very fine coaster. We'll go ahead and place the entrance and exit and then call it a day here. Call it an episode. Okay, so entrance, throw down. Oh, that's unfortunate. Okay, we're not throwing that down yet. We'll have to do some sort of weird serpentine maneuver here. I don't think that's enough space. Okay, we might have to just, like, add our own serpentine even back here. Because I'm thinking this is going to be a pretty popular coaster. At least that's my assumption. I'm not always right, of course, except for every time. But you know, who knows, honestly. Like, some of these coasters are crazy, some of them just get shit on. Oh, we can't do that, though. Okay. Oh, this is getting annoying. And back it up. No. We just a normal queue here. Okay. We can't do that. Over here, put it down. Okay. Even start it back here. We're just gonna go full serpentine maneuver. There we go. Let's leave some room for scenery around the queue and leave enough space for all this stuff. Okay, just like that. I think that's plenty long enough. We'll go ahead and throw the exit path down as well. Something like that. Okay. Well, thank you for watching this episode of Planet Coaster. I'm excited for this guy that we've just built. Hopefully it'll become quite a popular coaster. I like it. It is a compact thing that we built. But anyway, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.